Hello students, today's topic is K-maps. K-maps are used to minimize the number of literals in a Boolean expression. We can minimize the number of literals in a Boolean expression by using two ways. First method is Boolean algebra. We can minimize the number of literals or number of variables in a Boolean expression by using Boolean algebra. And the second method is K-map. We can minimize by using K-map. The drawback in the Boolean algebra is we can minimize the number of literals not in a systematic method. We can never sure that the minimal expression obtained is real minimal or not. So we go for K-map. K-map is a chart or a graph. It is composed an arrangement of adjacent cells, each representing a particular combination of variables in a sum form or product form. K-map can be used for problem involving any number of variables. The full form of K-map is Carnot map. If any expression has n variables, if any expression or a function has n variables, we can have 2^n possible combinations. These 2^n possible combinations are in two ways. First way is sum of product term. Second way is product of sum form. Sum of product form and product of sum form. In the sum of product form, all the variables are in product form. In between product form, we have OR operation is there. The example of SOP terms are x into y plus y into z. Now observe this x and y term. In the x and y term and y and z term, in between x and y relation is product term. Product operation is there. Same way, in between product terms we have OR operation is there. So, ORing the product terms, that is sum of products. In POS form, we have product terms. In between terms, we have product operation is there. The relation in between literals, we have OR operation. The example for POS operation is x plus y into y plus z. X plus y into y plus z. In between x and y, y and z, ORing operation is there. So in between OR operation, OR terms, in between OR terms relation and operation is there. So that is the product of sum form and sum of product. In the sum of product form, in between variables end operation is there, and the relation between two end operations is ORing the terms. In POS form, product terms in between relation is OR operation. So, ORing the product terms, that is POS. That is the representation of SOP and POS. Now see the representation of K-map. An n variable function has 2^n possible combinations. For example, a two variable K-map will have 2^2, so four cells. Four cells are squares are there. And same way, three variable map, we have 2^3 equal to 8 cells. And same way, four variable map, we have 2^4 equal to 16 cells are there. And same way, five variable map, we have 2^5 equal to 32 cells. 32 cells or 32 squares are there. And so on. Now see the representation of K map in two variable, three variable and four variable. See here, two variable map, we have 2 power 2 cells, 2 power 2. So we have four cells. The four cells are indicated with 0, 0. This is the representation of K map, two variable map. So this cell is 0th cell, first cell, second cell, third cell. So we can represent the four cells as 0 to 3. The total count of 0 to 3 is 4 cells. Same way, 3 variable map. In the 3 variable map, we have 2 power 3 equal to 8 cells. 2 power 3 equal to 8 cells. The 8 cells are like this. Next one, 4 variable map. In the 4 variable map, we have 2 power 4. So total we get 16 cells. This is the representation of 4 variable map. Same way, we have 1 variable map is also there. 1 variable map is also there. Now the representation of 1 variable map is, this is the representation of 1 variable map. So 0th cell, first cell. That is the representation of K map. Now see here, variable representation. First is one variable map. One variable map. In the one variable map, I am taking the example. This cell is A bar cell and it is A cell. Now coming to two variable map. In the two variable map, two variables are taken as A and B. So this row indicates, these rows indicates A variable and the columns indicates with B variable. Columns indicates with B variable. So this cell is, first cell is called it as A bar cell and B bar cell. Second cell is called as A bar cell B. And third cell is called as A B bar. And the fourth cell is called as 1 1. That means AB. AB. 0 indicates complement form. 1 indicates normal form. So see here, this is 0, 0, 0 cell. It is a 3 variable map. 3 variables are indicated with the variables A, B, C. It rows indicates variable A and it is A bar row and A row. Columns indicates with B and C. This column is B bar column and C bar column. And it is B bar C column and it is B C column, B and C, and it is B and C bar column. That is the representation of three variable. Now this cell is called as 0th cell. Why? Because this cell address is 0, 0, 0. 0, 0 means the decimal equivalent value for 0, 0 is 0. That's why it is 0th cell. Next cell is 1. It is, the cell location address is 0, 0, 1. So it is 1. Next one is 0, 1, 1. That means 3. And this cell address is 0, 1, 0. So it is 2. Next, this cell address is 1, 0, 0. 1, 0, 0 means 4. The decimal equivalent value is 4. Next value 1, 0, 1. So first row. And column value is 0, 1. That is equivalent to 5. Next, first row. Row is 1. And column is 1, 1. The decimal equivalent value for 1, 1, 1 is 7. Next, it is last cell. It is, row is 1. And column is 1, 0. The decimal equivalent value for 1, 1, 0 is 6. That is the representation of cells and its addresses. Now, coming to representation. So 0, 0, 0 cell is representing as A bar. 0 means complement form. That's why we are taking A bar, B bar, C bar is equal to 0, 0, 0. Next one is A bar, B bar, first cell, A bar, B bar, C. That is equivalent to 0, 0, 1. And third cell is A bar, BC, and second cell is A bar. 0 means A bar, or you can see here this row indicates A bar row, that's why I am writing A bar, and the column indicates B and C bar. Same way here, row indicates A, row address is A, and column address is B bar and C bar. Now coming to this value, row indicates A, or 1 indicates A, 0 indicates complement form, that is B bar, C. Here 7 means A, B, C, and 110 means row indicates A, column indicates B, and C bar. That is the representation of 3 variable map. Now see here 4 variable map. The 4 variables are I am taking as A, B, C, D. Now see the representation in 4 variable map. The rows indicate A and B, column indicates C and D. This column indicates C, D, and rows are indicated with AB. Now observe here, the row is 0, 0 means A bar, B bar. Why? Because 0 means complement form. This row indicates A bar B, and it is AB. This value is A, B bar. Same way column elements C bar, D bar, 0, 0. First row is 0, 0, that is C bar, D bar. Next, second row is C bar, D, second column. Third column is CD, and fourth column is CD bar. That is the representation of 4 variable map by using variables. So this cell, this the address of this cell is 0, 0, 0, 0. That means first two zeros are indicates with rows, second zeros are indicates with columns. The decimal value, equivalent value for 0 is 0, and the cell, second cell address is 0, 0, 0, 1. So the decimal equivalent value is 1. Now see here, this value is first row indicates with row. Row is 0, 0. Column is 1, 1. So the value is 3. Next, this cell, row is 0, 0. Column is 1, 0. So it is 2. Coming to second row, this row indicates 0, 1. Column is 0, 0. So this is the equivalent value for decimal equivalent value for 4. Next, this row cell, this cell belongs to 0, 1 row, 0, 1 column. So binary equivalent value for this value is, decimal equivalent value is 5, and this value is 0, 1, 1, 1. That is the 7. Next one, 0, 1, 1, 0, it is 6. Now see here, this row indicates 1, 1, column indicates 0, 0. It is the decimal equivalent value for 12. Now coming to this column, this cell, 1, 1 is the row value, column value is 0, 1. This is the decimal equivalent value, 13. Next one, this cell address is 1, 1. Again, column address is 1, 1. So this is the decimal equivalent value, 15. Next, this cell indicates 1, 1 row, 1, 0 column. So 1101 is the binary number. The decimal equivalent value for this binary number is 14. Now, last row. The last row is indicated with 10 row. Column is 00. So the decimal equivalent value for this binary number 1000 is 8. Next, this cell indicates 0810 row and column is 01. The decimal equivalent value is 9, and this cell is 1011. It is 11. Next, this cell is 1010. It is the decimal equivalent value for 10. Now see the representation of variables. This is the decimal and binary representation of 4 variable. Now coming to representation of variables is, see here, 15th cell I am taking first. So 1 indicates normal value, that means, so this cell address is AB and column address is CD. That is the representation. Now see this cell. This cell indicates A bar, B bar row. So A bar, B bar row, and column is C, D bar row. For this, you can observe here. This is the row is, row belongs to A, B bar, column belongs to C, D. Same way for this, row is A, B bar, column is C, D bar. For this cell, row is A bar B, column is C, D bar. And same way, this cell is row wise, row value is A, B bar, column is C bar, D bar. That is the representation of variables in a four variable map.